The Basque Country is located around the western side of the Pyrenees on the coast of the Bay of Biscay, and it's located in the north-central part of Spain and southwestern part of France. There is an old form of Basque graffiti that says that 4 plus 3 equals 1. There are Basque people who refer to the seven regions as Zazpiak Bat, which in English means the seven are one. The Basque Country is called Euskal Herria, Euskal, Eusk, el Euskera, the Basque language. Herria is the word for country. Also is known as Euskadi, and is considered Basque to the is considered home to the Basque language. Basque Euskaldunak are the people who have the Euskera, the people who have the Basque language. All these mountains are the place where you can find a lot of mythology. The archaeological sites also explain a lot of history and have a lot of mythology. I would like to mention José Miguel de Barandiarán, who is a Basque anthropologist. He is an important referent of the Basque culture. He says that there are a lot of myths of the Iberian, Gaelic, Latin, Nordic people who may remind us of our own myths. Because of this, our mythology, the Basque mythology, is no less original. For example, the myth of Mary. She was the queen of the spirits, and she personifies the earth. Mary is said to have several homes, all in high mountains, in caverns. Every 7 years, she used to change the houses, the caverns, by traveling through the air, maybe in Iberian Airlines, I don't know. And she was enveloped in a shaft of light. She condemns and punishes the telling of lies, theft, pride, and lack of respect towards others. And thanks to Mary, we get so much about our Amalur, or Mother Earth. Basahaun is another mythical character. He was the lord of the wood. And he's a strong man who lives in the heart of the wood. He's good, he has a good spirit, and he's the lord of the woods because he is responsible to the introduction of agriculture among the Basque people. So maybe with your students, when you talk about the Basque Country, you could talk among some of the things, about some of these things, about the mythology. Sorgiña, or witch, also is a kind of numen that takes the animal form, with the peculiarity that the animal is always missing a member, an arm, a leg, or something, and usually it takes the shape of a cat. Talking about Sorgiñak, or witches, there are caverns, the famous caverns of Zugarramurdi, that were the places where witchcrafts used to happen in the Middle Ages. And the Basque witch trials of the 17th century represent the most ambitious attempt to destroy the witchcraft practice. And you probably know that was due to the Spanish Inquisition at that time. I want to talk now a little bit about the Euskera. At the end, we can have the chance to see the video a little bit. And you know, there is a language of unknown origin. It has no relationship to Indo-European languages, or Uralic, or European families. Most linguists agree that it is probably the oldest language in Europe. And the Euskera has been influenced by other languages, Celtic, Latin, Castilian, and so on. And these languages also have benefited from the contributions of the Basque language. The literature has had an important oral tradition since many, many years, and the first literary texts appeared late in the 16th century, 1545. And in the transmission of the Basque culture, there was a role, a very important role played by the versolariac, versolaris in Spanish, or improvisers. These improvisers are poets, and they improvise a poem out of a particular word or out of a particular theme. You will see also in the video and the way that they operate. So they have been crucial in transmitting the Basque culture. And there is a renaissance on this aspect, cultural aspect. There are schools that teach versolarismo, versolaria izateko, to become versolaris. And the young people are very, very motivated to develop these particular cultural forms. There is a process of has been a process of linguistic normalization in the Basque country. Nowadays, it is said that there are at least 6 out of 10 young people who speak the Basque language. The teaching of Euskera in the autonomous community of the Spanish part is the most popular choice. There are Basque schools that teach everything through the Basque, okay? And then they have, you know, Spanish as a compulsory language also, and then a third and maybe a fourth foreign language. And there are nowadays also, in these years, there are trilingual experiences, Basque schools teaching Spanish, Basque, Euskera, Spanish and English. And they are having a trilingual experience to see how far that this experience reach. We have to say that there have been some administrative from the administration, from the government, some steps given, but we don't have to forget that a popular initiative has really had a real word on the maintenance and development of the Basque language. There were a lot of people. There are popular initiatives like the Kilometroa that consists of a march in which people donate maybe $1 or $2 or whatever for each kilometer that they walk, and the money collected is used to build another ikastola or Basque school. So, part of the culture, in the Basque culture, is that to be participative in and taking initiatives to do different things. We don't have to forget, my mother, for instance, she was a Basque speaker since she was little. When she was 10 years old, she went to the school, everything in Basque, to the Castola, and then when Franco arrived, he forbade the language, so she had to go to the Spanish school. My experience was different. She used to talk to us until, we were 4 or 5. Years old. My father spoke Spanish, so in the household, the main language was the Castilian language. I remember when they wanted to say something that they, for us not to know, they would speak in Basque, in Euskera. My mother spoke very, very well. My father, tried to. And then I have to learn the language. And it was not until college when I really took the initiative to recover what it was part of me. I had all the affective relationship with the language, and I found myself that I was learning French, I was learning English, and what I was doing with my mother tongue. So, and thanks to the situation, the social situation, and cultural consciousness of that surrounded me, I was able to recover and to learn and to be and continue learning. I'm still learning, and but it's fascinating. And there are many things. There are many, Basque Country is very alive. There are many celebrations. There are winter celebrations. There are summer celebrations. Winter celebrations can be related, to traditional customs. Like, for example, the Santo Tomás, Saint Thomas Fair that happens in Donostia, San Sebastián, the capital of Guipúzcoa, and Santa in Bilbao also. And this, when the peasants come to the city to show their products and to sell them, then there is Christmas, and in Christmas we have the tradition of the Olencero, which is a charcoal maker, and he's the one who dates from pre-Christian times. Then we have in Donostia the parade, the drum parade called Damborrada or Tamborrada, and of Donostia, of San Sebastian, and it is it lasts one entire day. It goes from midnight on January 19th until the 20th. It begins with the lifting of the flag of the city of San Sebastian, of Donostia, and it ends with the flag is put down. There are people, all town participates, adults. It begins with the march of the adult people, and then it's very emotive when all the children in the city begin to parade on the 20th at midday. And they go with uniforms from different troops. And of course, it's not that the people are celebrating the military aspect of it. It's more a mockery or something, you know, of the whole thing. And then we have another carnival celebration in January or in February, beginning of March. And that has been very, very important. My mother was from Tolosa. Tolosa was the town that kept the celebration of the carnival, even when it was forbade by Franco. And they kept the carnival, the tradition, under the name of the holiday celebration of the spring celebration. And it continues to be, like in other parts of Spain, the carnival also has an important tradition. Then you have, you know, summer festivities, holidays, and it's very interesting and it's neat, beautiful to see that, for example, the celebration begins in Iruña, you know, the San Fermines, then it goes to Bayona, the capital of Lapurdi, on the Basque-French side. Then the summer celebrations go, usually they last like 1 week, approximately. Then the celebration goes to Gasteiz, Vitoria, the capital of Álava, the other province, the Basque Autonomous Community. And then the celebration goes to San Sebastian, Donostia, for La Semana Grande, Aztenagusia, or the Great Week. And then it goes to Bilbao. So the celebrations go from capital to capital. And there's a good connection on that. If you are interested, I'm going to change a little bit the subject and moving from festivals to sports. You know, Basque sports are rooted in traditions, and there are modern sports also. The rooted, traditional Basque sports like stone lifters, arrijasotzaileak, we have log cutters, aizkolariak, we have grass cutters, segalariak, we have estropadak, or rowing, because, you know, we are by the ocean, and in saying this, I would like to remember that despite that the Basque people, you know, we like our protection and defend our territoriality and everything, we are open to go, to the world. And in fact, you know, the first person who went around the world, who was?
Italian.
He started the expedition. It was Juan Sebastián Elcano, the Basque marinero, who finished the expedition. Elcano from Getaria, a fisherman city town close to Donostia, San Sebastián. And as an sport, we have the tradition also of the sheepdog, because there were a lot of shepherds, Basque people who were shepherds. Of course, not to forget the Basque pilota, or jaialai, that you call. And jaialai, jai means festa, alai means happy. Okay, we don't call jaialai, we call escu pelota, or festa punta. Thank you very much, patience, and We will talk later on.